Hey Aztec fans, I'm Ryan Schuler for GoAztecs.com. Next week, the Aztec Hall of Fame will be inducting the class of 2012. So for this week's From the Archives, we are taking you back almost 20 years to show you the Hall of Fame videos from the class of 1994. Take a look.
This year, San Diego State pays tribute to five individuals whose outstanding contribution to the Aztec program and their accomplishments since earned them not only a place in the Hall of Fame, but the respect and admiration of their peers. The 1994 inductees played or coached for some of the greatest Aztec teams of all time. They established numerous records and milestones and include a 12-year professional, an Olympic champion, and an All-American. The greatest softball player in San Diego State history was Tricia Mang. At age 15, Mang was the youngest member of the ASA national champion San Diego Astros and was a first-team All-American. At Madison High School, her teams won three consecutive CIF titles. After being heavily recruited, she attended UCLA, where she was an All-American as a freshman in 1984. Her dramatic 13th inning home run won the national championship that year. In 1985, she was struck with a kidney disease and struggled through half of the season before coming home to redshirt in 86, and then play for the Aztecs in 87 and 88. While away from collegiate competition, Mang became a member of the U.S. national team, won her second ASA national championship, and was named an ASA All-American for the second and third times. In 1987, she came back to the collegiate game with a vengeance, completely rewriting the San Diego State record books. In two seasons as a pitcher and shortstop, Mang broke virtually every Aztec offensive record. She still holds the career marks for batting average, slugging percentage, total bases, home runs, and runs batted in. She also owns single season records for average, hits, doubles, home runs, slugging, and RBIs. Mang was a shoe-in for All-Conference and the Aztec Most Valuable Player in both years. Her statistics were far superior to several All-America players. In her senior season, Mang single-handedly led the team to a promising 18-10 mid-season record before suffering a knee injury. She not only led the team in all slugging statistics, but unlike most power hitters, also paced the club in stolen bases and had the fewest strikeouts. Currently married with a three-year-old son, Patricia Mang Jordan teaches middle school in Hawthorne, California. She was the softball team's first full scholarship player and is responsible for turning the Aztec softball program from a fledgling entity into a legitimate contender. Patricia Mang, a 1994 inductee into the Aztec Hall of Fame. One of only a handful of Aztecs to win a national championship and an Olympic gold medal is volleyball star Chris Marlowe. A high school volleyball All-American, Marlowe was recruited at San Diego State as a basketball player, but volleyball was his sport of destiny. It was 1973. The Aztecs were hosting the NCAA Volleyball Final Four at the Sports Arena. San Diego State was a huge underdog to the powerful Long Beach State 49ers. But the tide began to turn when the home team evened the match at one game apiece.
Put it up, leading 14-13. Out! San Diego State has won game number two by a score of 15-13.
This match would turn out to be one of several upset victories in Marlowe's storied career. The Aztecs rode the wave of fan support and shocked a rare national television audience with their first and only national title.
Long Beach State trying desperately to stay alive. Had a great season. They were the favorites coming into the championship tournament.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Chris Marlowe.
Marlowe would go on to have plenty to say during his career. He was an All-American for the Aztecs before joining the national team in 1974. He was the captain and team MVP in the 1976 Olympics, was voted the best player in America in 1977, and was again the team MVP for the 78 season. The United States Volleyball Association named him an All-American five times. On the beach, Marlowe won the World Championship in 1977, and in July 1994, he was inducted into the California Beach Hall of Fame. At the end of 1978, Marlowe's career took a detour when he left the game to pursue an acting career. He also started broadcasting volleyball, and he is now referred to as the voice of volleyball, having announced for seven networks covering every major volleyball event in the world. But after 4 years away from the game, Marlowe knew there was one more goal to reach on the court. And in 1982, he returned to the U.S. team, and 2 years later, he reached his crowning achievement. He captained the 1984 Olympic team to its first gold medal. In 1993, SDSU held a 20-year reunion for the school's only Division I national champs. During the ceremony, Marlowe became one of eight players in Aztec athletic history to have a jersey retired. Chris Marlowe, a 1994 inductee into the Aztec Hall of Fame. The Aztec football program has a fabulous history of success, conference championships, undefeated seasons, and bowl game victories. The coach who first experienced these milestones was Bill Schutte. From 1947 to 55, Schutte's team set the tone for future Aztec accomplishments. In his second season as head coach, he led San Diego State to its first bowl game, the 1948 Harbor Bowl. 3 years later, the Aztecs garnered their first unbeaten season and first bowl victory when they went 10-0-1 and crushed Hawaii in the 1951 Pineapple Bowl 34-13. While Schutte celebrated on the islands with Aztec Hall of Famers Art Preston and Charlie Smith, he was basking in the glory of back-to-back conference titles as well. Schutte went full circle to become the Aztec coach. After moving to San Diego at age 14, he starred on the football, basketball, and baseball teams at San Diego High. He then played football and baseball for the University of Idaho before taking a coaching job at Kansas State. Coaching was destined to become Schutte's career. Even World War II couldn't keep Schutte from the athletics he loved so much. While in the Navy, he ran physical fitness programs in the South Pacific. After the war, he returned to Montezuma Mesa, where he won more games than any Aztec coach in the program's first 30 years. He currently trails only Don Coryell and Claude Gilbert on the all-time Aztec win list, but he was the man who planted the seed for the Aztec football tradition. Bill Schutte, a 1994 inductee into the Aztec Hall of Fame. The most celebrated teams in the history of the Aztec Hall of Fame are the football teams from the late 60s. Head coach Don Coryell and eight players from that era have been inducted. This year, San Diego State enshrines a ninth player from that golden age. undisputed leader of the 1967-68 defensive backfield and the catalyst of the special teams, was Nate Wright. Number 27 led the Aztecs in punt return yardage in both years, and he's third on the all-time return yardage list. In 1967, the Aztec attendance more than doubled. Wright returned both a punt and an interception for a touchdown as he helped the Aztecs to the College Division National Championship. In only two seasons, Wright made the top 10 list in interceptions for a program that has sent 19 defensive backs to the NFL. He picked off four passes in 1967 and grabbed five more to lead the team in 68. He was among the most successful professionals to come out of the Aztec program, playing 12 years in the NFL. 10 of those seasons were spent with the legendary Purple People Eaters, the Minnesota Vikings, and included three Super Bowl appearances. Nate Wright, a 1994 inductee into the Aztec Hall of Fame. In the history of Aztec basketball, no coach comes close to the win total of George Ziegenfuss. From 1948 to 1969, Ziegenfuss's teams won 316 games, over 100 more than the next highest total. During that record 22-year reign, San Diego State finished first in the conference five times and second six times, as Ziegenfuss ended his Aztec coaching career with a .580 winning percentage. Under Ziegenfuss, the Aztecs reached the NAIA tournament twice, and in 1966, he led San Diego State to the quarterfinals of the NCAA Small College Tournament. Before coming to Montezuma Mesa, Ziegenfuss was an accomplished athlete in his own right. He was captain and most valuable player of both the baseball and basketball teams at the University of Washington, and was named All-Coast in basketball as a senior. The Ziegenfuss family has carried on the athletic tradition of their father. His son, Fritz, is the only boys basketball coach in Patrick Henry High School's history, and daughter, Valerie, is a former top 10 professional tennis player and one of the original eight members of the Women's Tennis Association, which included Billie Jean King. Ziegenfuss's 22 years of coaching success at San Diego State was matched by a 32-year teaching career. Through all the records and winning seasons, Ziegenfuss is more proud of his academic accomplishments, teaching physical education. In a campus-wide poll, he was twice named the university's outstanding professor. George Ziegenfuss, a 1994 inductee into the Aztec Hall of Fame.